In the partner tutorial B video, you're going to be learning how to use the Revolve tool to actually create a bowl. We're going to start by making a 2D sketch of just a part of a bowl, and then we're going to use the Revolve tool to bring it all around. So we're going to hit 2D sketch, and we're going to actually hit the X and the Z plane because we're going to make the bowl go around the bottom. So this is really important that you get your measurements right. When you select the line tool, you'll know that you're rightly lined up with things when it's a green dot. When you're not connected, it'll be yellow. When you're absolutely connected, it'll be green. So we're going to start by clicking on the center point. We're going to come along here and just create a small line along that bottom and click again. Then we're actually going to use the arc tool. You can use the arc tool by 3 points. So again, I'm going to make sure it's green. I'm going to click where I want my arc to start. I click where I want it to end, and then I can get my bend going on. That'll be my third click. So it's a three-click process. A bowl is normally round at the bottom, so we're going to go ahead and click here. Now we're going to make another arc that comes out this way. So again, I'll make sure that it's lined up by finding that green dot. I'll click once, I'll click twice where it's going, and then the third click will allow me to create that arc shape so I can make it as arc-y as I need to. So we'll create this to be like a normal bowl. We'll go ahead and click it here. And it's okay if yours doesn't look exactly like mine. Just make sure those dots are matched up. Now we're going to go back to the line tool. We're going to again get that green dot matched up, click, and just bring it out a little bit. This is like the edge or the lid of your bowl. I'll click it one more time. Now we're going to start to go back and make the inside of the bowl. So we're going to click the arc tool. Again, we click at the beginning of the line. We click at the end of the line, and then we give it a nice arc. Now, these two lines need to be parallel to each other. So we're actually going to use a constraint. A constraint allows you to make things equal. So we're going to use this equal constraint. I click on it, and I click the two lines that I want to be there. It may shorten it up, and that's okay. It's just trying to make sure that they're equal distance from each other. So again, I hit the equal tool, I selected the tool that I want, and it made sure that they were nice and equal. We're going to come back to the arc tool. We're going to make sure our green lines are dotted. We're going to click once, click twice, and then allow us to create the inside. Again, we want these two lines to be constrained. So we'll click the equal constraint, click the first line, click the second line, and it may again change it a little bit. That's okay. Now the last thing we need to do is finish off the profile of this bowl. So I'm going to come back to the line tool. I'm going to carefully make sure my lines are matched up, bring it back to that line, and then drop it back to my first point. I'll know I'm there when it's green. So now I've got a fully formed profile of a bowl. Okay. So I'll come back to my home here. I'm going to finish the sketch. Now, in the 3D model tab, I'm going to use this Revolve. When I click on Revolve, I first need to select the profile, and I do that by just clicking on the shape I made. Then I click on the axis. This is going to be where you want it actually to turn around and finish it. So I actually want the whole bowl to move on this edge right here. So I'm going to click that edge, and I'll click OK. And now you can see that I do have a really wide top to my bowl, but I have a fully realized actual bowl using the Revolve tool. Now, if I really want to go ahead and extend this out, you don't have to teach this to your partner, but eventually you should try it. I can actually go ahead and right click on different parts of my bowl and come to properties, and I can actually start to change what this bowl is going to look like. There's a lot of ways to change appearances. This is just one of the ways that you could actually start to make it look a little bit more clear.